Come on, make some noise and hear some hallelujah. Because there ain't nobody can say I'm a blessed Lord at all times. And it's praise shall continue to be in my mouth. If you got a praise on the inside out there, then give God some praise in here. Say yes. Yeah. Come on, come on, say yes. I don't know my child, but God has been real good. Hallelujah. Is there anybody that came to give God some praise on tonight? Come on, this is young people on tonight. Come on, young people, can y'all just make some noise for Jesus in this place? Come on, come on, Shabbat the Lord tonight. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Most gracious Father, we thank you now, God, for this service, God. Lord, thank you, God, for the songs that have went up before you, God. Lord, thank you, God, for this youth explosion, God. God, we ask you to move Jerome out of the way, God. God, you do the preaching and the teaching, God. Touch somebody, set somebody free, God. Heal, deliver, God. Move in a mighty special way, God. Move every hindering and blocking spirit out the door right now in the name of Jesus. God, send your anointing, my God. Send your power. God, send your glory, God. Shower down in this place, God. Lord, we plead, God. We're thirsty. We're hungry for you, God. God, we speak now, God. We preach peace, God. We preach deliverance tonight. In the name of Jesus, have your way, God. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost, I so pray. Amen. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Amen. Y'all look quieter in here tonight. If y'all could just give God some praise just for a moment. Come on, this is youth night, and we came to encourage the youth. Come on, just make some noise for Jesus in this place. Come on, y'all can do a little better than that. If Jesus was to come right now, what would you do? Come on, that's a little better. Now give him some standing and honor him right now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We bring you greetings from Miracle Redeemer, Full Gospel Church, out of Bethel, where the pastor is my district overseer, Lady Gamichi. Y'all give her a hand. Amen. It's good to see Pastor Tarita Johnson and her husband, Co-Pastor Johnson. Y'all give them a hand. Amen. And Minister Borders, amen, to all the elders and ministers out there. Y'all pray with me. And to Minister Smith, again, thank you for inviting me. Amen. And y'all go with me to, I just lost my scripture, so y'all pray with me. Amen. To come back to me. Amen. Amen. Come on and go with me to Genesis, the 32nd chapter. Amen. And when you have it, say amen. You can stand in reference to reading of the word. Amen. I won't be before you long, but there is a word from the Lord. Amen. Amen. That's Genesis 32. Amen. So Jacob went on his way, and the angels of God met him. When Jacob saw them, he said, "This is God's camp." And he called the name of the place Manam. Then Jacob sent messengers before him to Esau, his brothers, in the land of Seir, the country of Edom. And he commanded them, saying, "Speak thus to my..." Hold on, y'all. Got the wrong scripture. Amen. Go to the, we're going to start at the 22nd verse. Amen. "And he arose that night and took his two wives, his two female servants, and his 11 sons, and crossed over the ford of Jabbok. He took them, sent them over to the brook, and sent over what he had. Then Jacob was left alone, and a man wrestled with him until the breaking of day. Now when he saw that he did not prevail against him, he touched the socket of his hip, and the socket of Jacob's hip was out of joint as he wrestled with him. And he said, 'Let me go, for the day breaks.' But he said, 'I will not let you go unless you bless me.' So he said to him, 'What is your name?' He said, 'Jacob.' And he said, 'Your name shall no longer be called Jacob, but Israel. For you have struggled with God and with man and have prevailed.' Then Jacob asked, saying, 'Tell me your name, I pray.' And he said, 'Why is this that you ask about my name?' And he blessed him there." You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. We're going to use for a thought or a sermon tonight, "I won't let go until you bless me." Come on, touch your neighbor. Say, "Neighbor, I won't let go until you bless me." Turn around and tell somebody. Say, "Neighbor, I won't let go until you bless me." Come on and put those sanctified hands together in this place.
Amen. It said that he arose that night and took his two wives, his two female servants, and 11 sons, and crossed over to the ford of Jacob. He took them, sent them over to the brook. Amen. Amen. At this time, we're talking about Jacob. We're talking about how Jacob, he wrestled with the angels. How Jacob, he pleaded to the Lord for his healing, because Jacob, he said, in spite of what Jacob was going through in this scripture, he said, I won't let go until you bless me. Jacob began to pray. Jacob began to seek God because he knew that God was going to pull him through. Can I get a witness? Is there anybody here that done been through a storm and done been through a rain? It seemed like you're wrestling with the angels. It seemed like the devil is on one end and God is on the other. Can I get a witness? Well, I came to tell you that it's only a test. Can I get a witness? It's only a test just to bring you through. We might be going through heartaches and we might be going through pain, but still, we got to keep on wrestling with God. Sometime in our life, we find that we come up against wicked things. We find, like being a teenager or just a young man or a young woman, we find that we're going to come up against peer pressure. Am I right? But you got to stay in the hands of God, because he said that I will never leave you nor will I forsake you. See, I believe Jacob kept on praying. He kept on fasting. He kept on believing that God was going to heal him. Can I get a witness? While Jacob was in the midst, God was still in the midst of it all. Is there anybody who can say that you won't let go until God bless you? You can't let go, because everything that happens for a reason, it is God. Can I get a witness? God won't put more on you than you can bear. See, you might be going through a storm in your life. You might be going through trials and tribulations. But I promise you that God won't. He won't leave you. Am I right about it? He didn't leave Jacob. Jacob was healed in the midst of the situation. Jacob began to wrestle. He began to talk to God. How many know that sometimes we have to lay awake and just pray and moan and just seek God for the things that God is getting ready to do? Can I get a witness in here? Is there anybody here that can be, that have been sick in their body, and it just seemed like the devil was all in your body? It seemed like there was no hope. It seemed like there was no peace. But I came to tell you that the peace of God, it passes all understanding. Tell somebody, say, the peace of God, it passes all understanding. See, we got so many that's going on around us. So many young folks getting killed and dying on every hand. But I come to tell you just to stay in the race. Am I right about it? Because the race isn't given to the swift, nor to the strong, but it's given to the one that endure to the end. Tell somebody, say, I'm going to endure to the end. Don't listen to the enemy. The enemy is telling you, you can't make it, you won't make it, but my God said he'll be right there to the ends of the earth. Can I get a witness in here? Well, I won't let go until God heal me, just like Jacob. You got to have a Job-like spirit. Do you remember Job was sick for so long and flesh fell from his bone, but Job was still praying. He still was seeking God because he was a man of integrity, because he still stood the test of times. Is there anybody in here that have been beat on, you've been lied on, you've been mistreated, but my God still saw you through? He gave you hope for tomorrow. Am I right about it? He gave you peace in the midst of the storm. Can I get a witness in here? I wish I had somebody that said, I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth. How many college students do we have in here? You get ready to go back to school. Don't get discouraged, but just know that God is walking along. God has a plan, and he has a purpose for you. You might be tested in the fire. You might be going through the storm while you're doing your work, but God said, just seek me, and I'm with you. He said, I'll never leave you, nor will I forsake you. Tell somebody, say, God won't leave me alone. I don't have to worry about it, because I know that the Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? Whom shall I be afraid? Am I right about it in here? I wish I had some young people that's on fire for God tonight. They can say that the angels are still there. When it just looked like there was no way, who was right there? Jesus. Can I get a witness in here? I won't let go until you set me free. Some of you been bound too long, but God gonna loose the shackles and set you free. You have been dealing with depression, but my God said, I see you through. In spite of it all, he said, I'm not forgotten about you. Because he said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Can I get a witness here? Yeah. That no man cometh to the Father except by him. Can I get a witness? Is there anybody here dealing with a circumstance in their life? I come to tell you tonight that God's going to break every every chain. If you just claim it in the blood of Jesus. See, I come to tell somebody that the blood still works. Because I won't let go until you set me free. Is there anybody here that's going through a storm right now? But don't give up on God, because he won't give up on you. You've been tested through the trials. You've been tested through pain. But God said, I'm there with you. Don't you let go. You can't let go. Did Jacob let go? No, Jacob didn't let go. Jacob kept on fasting. Jacob kept on praising him. I come to encourage somebody to tell you that you need to praise God in the midst of your mess. Tell somebody, say, I got to keep on praising him in the midst of my mess, because I can't let go. I might get a little lonely sometime, but I come to tell you tonight that all your help, it comes from the Lord. It don't come from Buddha. It don't come from Usher. It's God Almighty. It don't come from little Bow Wow, but it comes from the man above. You might be messed up. You might be lied on. You might be mistreated. Tell you that you gotta keep on wrapping in the arms of Jesus, because he will. Good God Almighty, I feel like preaching it here. I said he will see you through. You might feel like you're all alone, but my God will be right there. Is there anybody here that can say that you look unto Jesus, because he's the author and the finisher of your faith? I come to tell you tonight that whatever you're going through, bills are due. I wish I had a prayer church. It seemed like the enemy wants to step in, but I come to tell you that my God is walking with you. He has his angels all around you. Good God Almighty, is there anybody here say, I'm blessed right now? I'm blessed in the midst of the curse, because God's going to break it if you just believe. He has deliverance. Your deliverance is on the way. I come to tell somebody, you laid in a bed all night long and you cried all night long. I came to tell you that weeping may endure for a night. So somebody might get some joy in here. Good God Almighty, I said that the joy of the Lord is your strength. You've been bound up for too long, but God said it's time to shake it off. It's time to shake it loose. He's getting ready to bless you like never before. Is there anybody here that can say, I've been through the storm, I had to deal with some things? You begin to sit in your room all night long and you cried, you weep and moan. You're like, Lord, come on, say, Lord, I need you right now. I need peace in my life. I need strength in my life. Dealing with a lot of things, but I come to tell you that you are a winner for Christ. Tell somebody, say, I am a winner. Come on, I am a winner. Come on, somebody tell them, you got the victory tonight. Good God Almighty, I see victory in here. Is there anybody here that can say that God will be right there? Hold on. My God said, you shall not be moved. No matter what it looks like, no matter what it feels like, no matter what it seems like. You don't have to be rich. You don't have to be poor. You can be black. You can be white. You can even be ugly. You can be all sedentary. But I come to tell you that my God, I'm gonna tell you that the enemy's been talking.
talking to you. Say, come on, man. Come on, woman. Go ahead and just shoot yourself. Go ahead and take your life. I'm talking to the young people. Even the older people. We go through some time. Can I get a witness? We might be struggling with a lot of things in our life. And we feel like we had to cry. We had to weep and moan. But my God still had an angel. He still had an angel standing by. He didn't leave you. Tell somebody, say, God didn't leave me by myself. Sometimes you might feel like you're all alone. But I come to tell you, he getting ready to bless you like never before. Tell somebody, say, the blessing is on the way. You might be cursed for too long. You might be bound up for too long. But God wants to free your mind. See, sometimes you have to just lay awake at night. I learned how to lay awake and just begin to pray. Because I knew that there was somebody there that was there for you. Can I get a witness? It seemed like people didn't love you. But my God loves you unconditionally. Can I get a witness in here? See, we don't have to worry about anything because God is right there. You said that sometimes you might be messed up. You might be dealing with a lot of things. You might have felt left alone, but still God had forgot about you. Why? Because the breakthrough is in your praise. I wish I had somebody that just looked at and say, the breakthrough is in my praise. Come on, if you just made some noise for Jesus, he's gonna pull you through tonight. Come on, tonight is your night for deliverance. Tonight is your night to be blessed. You've been dealing with it. The battle is not yours. It's the Lord. I come to tell you tonight, my God is fighting for you. Good God Almighty, you might be a preteen. You might be just a little child. You might be a teenager. You might be a young adult. But just remember, my God is stepping in right there. And I'm praying to the sources. I'm praying to the Lord. And it's the evidence. I'm praying to the sea. Just a little faith to give my blessing. For I know that when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all that he's done for me, I gotta keep on pressing. I gotta keep on pressing. Is there anybody that said I gotta press towards a mark of the higher calling? Which is in Christ Jesus. But God has a promise. God has a promise for you. Put those hands together, give God some praise. See, you're looking at a young man. I don't do the partying and drinking and everything. Not saying that I'm not young and I ain't been tempted, because I have, amen. Can I get a witness in here? But see, when you're in the arms of God, our pastor always taught us that you're anointed, appointed, and approved. I want each and every young person to know that you're anointed, appointed, and approved here tonight. God has a purpose for you. God has a destiny for you. God has not forgotten about you. It may look dark now. It may look rough now. You might be dealing with a lot of temptations, but just know that my God has not forgotten about you, because you have won the victory. Tell somebody, say, I won the victory. Victory shall be mine tonight. Somebody say, victory shall be mine. Turn around, 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 turn around pulled you out. He pulled you out of your storm. He pulled you out of your rain. He pulled you out of the hell that you've been through. You've been in prison for too long. Get up out of your seat. Come on, get up out of your seat. And tell your neighbor. Say, neighbor, grab your neighbor by the hand. I'm gonna praise in this place. Hey, look. God's getting ready to pull you out of the stuff you've been through. I think you're pulling me out of heaven before. Just pull him. Pull him into the victory. That's what that's just for the most shy of the moment. Pastor Johnson.
Pastor, we have an altar call. We have an altar call. It seems like you've been bound up for too long. But God's getting ready to set you free. Can I get a witness in here? Yes, God.